Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you how to convert mouse movements to WASD, depending on which way you move the mouse. This is perfect if you're physically disabled and can't use a keyboard. It is very useful for playing games. A lot of games nowadays use WASD for movement. This is very easy to set up. Let's get started. I'll be leaving all the download links that you need in the video description. The first thing you're going to want to do is download and install AutoHotkey. So click the green download button and click download current version. Go through the setup and install the program. It is very self-explanatory. You also need VJoy. You can download this with the link I have left in the description. Just click the green download button, wait till it downloads, and go through the setup. The installation is very straightforward as well. The next thing you're going to want to do is go to the MediaFire link in the description and download the mouse to joystick AutoHotkey program. Just click the blue download button. I give Helgef full credit to creating this script. This video wouldn't be possible without him. I just re-uploaded the script to MediaFire in case it gets removed. Once it's downloaded, place it on your desktop. Right-click it and extract it. Open the folder, and you should see these files. You need to make sure you have AutoHotkey, otherwise you can't open the script. Double-click mouse to joystick. Go to your tray icon, and you should see it here. Right-click it and click Settings. This window should open up. Click General and make sure for Output Mode, Mouse to Keyboard is selected. Next, where it says Mouse to Keyboard, click Keys. This is where you get to select what each mouse movement does on the keyboard. So I'm going to set up on the mouse to be W, down to be S, and right to be D, and left to be A. You can also make it so left and right click press a key on the keyboard. Let's go ahead and open up a game and set it up. I'm going to be testing this on Soulstone Survivors. It's a pretty fun roguelike game. So the first thing you're going to want to do is go to the settings and make sure the game is running in windowed mode. In order to use this script, the game has to be in windowed mode. Next, you're going to want to check out the key bindings for the game. Once we see the controls for the game, we can decide what settings to change in the script. So go back to your tray icon and right-click the script and click Settings. Click Keys to check out your configuration. And as we can see, everything lines up so far. So for this game, we're lucky because we can rebind Dash and learn skills without using the AutoHotkey program. So we're going to click Dash and left-click on our mouse. And go to learn skills and right click on our mouse. So looking through the game settings, I've also found auto level up. This opens the level up interface by itself every time you get a level. So now you need to make sure the script is selecting the correct process. So go to your tray icon, right click the script, click select game, and click the game window. So in order to start and stop the script, you need to click the Windows key plus the S key on your keyboard. I can't do that because I can't use a keyboard. To solve this, I am also using voice attack. As you can see, I have a command here that says joystick. So whenever I say the word joystick, it presses the left Windows key and S at the same time. So usually in the menu of the games, I keep it off, but when I'm actually in the game playing, I turn the script on. Let's go ahead and test it out. I'm going to say the word joystick to turn on the script. Joystick. As you can see, I'm moving my mouse around to move in-game. In this game, you auto-attack, which is nice. You could easily modify this script for any game though. See, I got a level, so now I need to choose my skill point. I'm gonna stop the script so I can move my mouse around and choose any of the three. Joystick. I'm gonna click it and then start the script again. Joystick. See, as you can see, with this setup, I can fully play the game now. This game would otherwise be inaccessible to me. If you have any questions, just leave a comment and I will help you. If this video helped you, please like it and subscribe to my channel. I would really appreciate it.